Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to Stage Fever. We are proud to present to you tonight, at great expense to the management, the I Spy Bumper Guide to Furry Stage Shows. So, without any further delay, sit back as we bring you the horror and take you on a thrilling roller coaster ride through all that's best and worst in furry variety show entertainment.
At number one, we have the old favorite, dancing along to music. Make sure it's your favorite piece of music. And remember, if you're performing with friends, be certain to make your choice fairly and democratically. It doesn't even have to be appropriate or recognizable. Just jump on stage and move in a vaguely rhythmic style, either in or out of time, to your well-chosen song. Air guitar is, of course, highly encouraged, if not mandatory. And whatever you do, don't even shorten the song in question. The longer the better. On the musical theme, next up is singing in costume. It doesn't matter how great a singer you are, there is nothing like 6 inches of foam to make you sound like you're shrieking through an old sock. To compensate for this slight impairment, remember to increase your volume accordingly, even at the expense of tonal quality. Many who take costuming very seriously. As everyone knows, if you spend your entire student loan on fake fur and foam, you will immediately be transformed into your animal spirit. What better way to display this than a deep, meaningful, and thought-provoking display of contemporary dancing? Remember, bonus points can be picked up if the wrong music is played and the audience doesn't even notice. At number four, we whisk you away to the magical world of the circus. Now, every profession has its highs and lows, and in the big top, spinning poi represents the bottom end. Twirling a few balls on the end of strings is dead easy, even for the most unskilled performer. As a bonus, it can actually look quite impressive to the untrained eye. Only a complete fool could mess this up. Now, if you're desperate for a crowd pleaser, you can't go wrong with a bit of internet culture. Showing your audience something they've already seen online will guarantee you endless shouting and wailing. Even better if it's a competition. You can be assured of a vote winner here.
Come on, reanimate your feet.
As the great ceiling cat would say, I can has no imagination now, please. Next up, jokes that only a handful of people will get. Whilst great fun for those in the know, for everyone else in the audience, you can often be left feeling as if you're missing out on something. now. Some people spend months and months preparing that big blockbuster number. An incredibly complicated piece, beautifully choreographed with 1,000 props, hundreds of sound and lighting cues, and a set design that would make Lord of the Rings seem like a school nativity play. Sadly, in all the excitement, they often forgot one crucial ingredient. Not even 1 minute's rehearsal. If all else fails, if the show is getting closer and if you really can't think of anything better, you can always fall back on that old convention favourite, a Monty Python sketch. They were always very funny, and maybe if you copy them, you will be funny too.
Finland, 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 that's my country for me.
Finland is the country where we dance, Finland is the country where we play. Here in Finland, boy and girl can find a true romance in traditional Scandinavian way.
Slip, slap,
slap a day.
Slip, slap,
slap a day all day.
Slip, slap,
you simply can't go wrong in traditional fish slapping song.
Next up is that other surefire vote winner, sex. Let's face it, by sexing something up, you could sell anything to anyone. Why not score an immediate hit with the audience by combining this fact with any number of things? Remember to squeeze in a large innuendo whenever you get the chance. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, we have those acts that are simply just too damn long. Rather like this one, really.